26-year-old Janet Nangobi is a widow. She lived with her late husband, Kabi Fenekansi, in Gwembuzi Village, Bukoma Sub-County, Luka District, before he died in 2020. Nangobi narrates that her in-laws evicted her because she only had girls with the deceased. My husband died in 2020. We were six wives, and he had given all of us property. But since I only have a daughter, his relatives told me to go and find a new husband. The female child was no anchor to the home. Nangobi says when the authorities intervened and stopped her eviction, the in-laws bullied her by destroying her crops in the garden. She was overwhelmed and had to leave. When I refused to leave, they reported me to the probation officer, who advised them to leave me alone, to let me live in my husband's home. But they refused. They resorted to sinister tactics, destroying my crops. Deborah Nachiyuka, another widow at Bumana Village, Bukanga Sub-County in the same district, was also evicted after her husband died. She says her stepson teamed up with clan members to chase her away. When I joined the family, my stepson was very young. I helped to raise him. But when his father passed away, he turned against me. He joined other clan members to grab all the property. They said as a woman, I had no right to any property.
In a month, around 40 cases that we do receive generally. Those ones, they are the cases that come through my office. But remember, we have even other stakeholders or offices which handle the same cases. So percentage-wise, out of 100, we are at around 70%.
In the probation and social welfare office of Iganga, we receive 5 cases a week, or roughly 15 to 20 cases a month of land grabbing or property grabbing of widows and orphans in Iganga district. And in most cases, when people are chosen as the heir to the deceased, they think everything, every property that belongs to the deceased belongs to them, which isn't at times right.
Office has been around for like 1 year now, and I don't have the cases of head, but we have done more than 70 cases, I think. They could even be more. Cases are definitely many, and every day we find that abuse kind of grows. Why? Because people are not aware of their rights. And when people are not aware of their rights, you can't fight for rights that you don't know that they accrue to you. So we are saying that the only way we are going to see cases decline is to take the information out there and let people know that it is wrong for you to evict widows. It is wrong for you to intermeddle in the estates of deceased persons.
In an effort to curb such cases, staff from NGO Redeem International held a meeting with the judiciary and police officials. The Iganga High Court judge asked leaders to sensitize the community about the rights of the widows and orphans, as well as help secure letters of administration.
Having cases of letters of administration, what they have is lack of awareness about their succession rights, how they should protect their estates. And this is where our big lawyer Redeem to concentrate. Once somebody has become a widow or an orphan, the first stage of helping should be putting together the estates.
The NGO has so far helped Nangobi, Nachiyuka and others in legal battles against their in-laws to get their property back. Report by Ivan Wachiri for the news.